Happy Monday, B-Fam! Alam nyo ba, today is Job Action Day. Tama-tama, Monday na Monday, work po tayo, opo. This day recognizes the importance of our careers and the impact that they have on our lives. Siyempre, no, any career has its ups and downs sometimes as we face yung mga setbacks, challenges, or even the need for a fresh start. But no matter what you've been through, you know, or kumbaga, kung dati, mga napagdaanan mo, or you're currently going through right now, know that you can always come back stronger naman. And you're still with me, your Bornix boy, PJ Miranda, only here on The Place to Be. Be happy, be you, be Brgy. You know, B-Fam, our professional lives may sometimes face a job loss, kumbaga, a career change, kumbaga yung workplace din natin, naghihirap din tayo sometimes, or yung mga difficulties na yan, or we may feel like being stuck also in a rut. It's during these challenging moments that we experience growth. And yun ang ating pag-uusapan for today. Our guest embodies a remarkable comeback story and she's someone who has been in the spotlight at a very, very young age. But as she grew older, she faced a series of challenges that led her to step away from the limelight for quite a while. But today, she is ready to share how she came back stronger. Kaya naman, it's now time to speak out and say it. Joining us today is one of the finalists from The Voice Kids Season 2 who was once dubbed as Lea Salonga's Mini Me. She released two singles such as Praising Hours and Heartbeat in 2022 and is now back with a new song. Let's welcome Esang de Torres! Hello, hello! Welcome to Brgy! Hello, grabe nakakatito! Laki-laki mo! And welcome. Say hi naman sa mga B-Fam natin watching us all over the world.
Hi to all our B-Fams watching all of, you know, watching all over the world. Thank you so much for watching and being with us.
Kamusta ka naman? Ano yung the past few days or the past few weeks?
The past few weeks I've been doing great. Sinasabi ko po yung school and you know career. Meron po akong kaka-release na song.
Ooh,
and title, okay. You know, Hold Me. Yun po. And it's a song that I wrote as well and I was able to produce it with under the label Police Records. Mm-hmm. And yun po yung pinagkakabalan ko at the moment.
And yun na nga, you started at the age of 3 when it comes to singing. Super, super aga mo nag-start. Naalala mo ba yung specific moment from your early childhood that really ignited your love for singing?
Specific moment for me, I think it would really be the time when I would sing karaoke. Like I would, yung sa karaoke machine, I would be singing with my family as our way of bonding.
Ano yung go-to song mo? Ano ba?
Go-to song ko po talaga, yung Tomorrow, yung Listen. Tomorrow sa from the Annie the Musical, Listen by Beyonce.
Laki ng changes from Tomorrow.
From Broadway to Listen. Grabe, beat it po talaga. Pinaka nag-start po ako, that would be when I was 2. But of course, hindi ko na po siya naalala.
Yep.
But that was when my parents would always tell me na I would be singing inside the crib along with the music. Pag may nagpa-play like, sa TV or sa radio, I would be humming with it. So I would dance along the song.
So may mga early signs na pala.
Music
industry talaga ang papasukan mo. And speaking of early signs, no, today naman talaga mag-throwback tayo dito dahil meron akong gift sa'yo. Nako, hinanap ko pa ito kung saan-saan. So we have here a quick photo album na napaka-cute with some of your photos. Na, for example, ito, from The Voice Kids. So, pag-usapan natin ito. Ayan, labot ko muna sa'yo.
So, this one, this picture was from The Voice Kids Season 2. I think this was when I had parang a duet with Ella and Stephanie for this.
That specific photo.
This specific photo.
You were also a finalist na for this one, the Season 2 natin. And how has this show really impacted your music career? Kasi you joined competitions prior to The Voice Kids, eh, di ba?
Okay.
So, paano nito na-boost yung confidence mo?
Yung The Voice?
Yeah.
I think it's also the one of the factors that boosted my confidence when it comes to The Voice Kids. Apart from the fact na mas iba po talaga yung exposure niya.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, lahat talaga nakaabang pag The Voice.
The Voice Kids, po talaga. Pag The Voice nun, like, nakaabang po yung mga nasa bahay, nanonood. Mm-hmm. It would also be, you know, this one very special person, si Coach Lea po talaga. Mm-hmm. She was able to help me boost my confidence when it comes to, you know, performing. Kasi before The Voice Kids, I joined like this segment from, you know, It's Showtime.
Yeah.
And this was when I...
Dito po sa
mini-me. Yun po yung time na mini Lea Salonga po yung ginampanan ko doon. Mm-hmm. Nakita po niya ako, tapos pinakanta po niya ako. Pinasample niya ako ng song, I Enjoy Being a Girl, from the Flower Drum Song musical. And then Coach Lea saw it, and then she was like, she was amazed.
Napakagaling Coach Lea, talagang ni-represent yung buong Philippines sa Broadway also. Ano yung feeling mo yung greatest lesson na shinare ni Coach Lea sa'yo?
I think this, I would always tell this in interviews po talaga, as in, the greatest one would be to sing with my whole heart.
Yung parang sinasabi ng mga judges palagi na parang magaling ka pero walang emotion.
Walang emotions. Ganyan. And yung storytelling po talaga. Mm-hmm.
Tapos, so talagang na-instill na agad sa'yo na gusto mo ba sumasali ng contest? Or parang was it something parang your family wanted you to do also? Or?
It's both.
Uh-huh.
Yung tatay ko po, si tatay. The reason why na-nurture din po siya, besides of course my mom, kasi siya po talaga yung nag-aalaga po sa akin. Si tatay din po when it comes to music. He was once a band vocalist and a theater
actor. Oh, so sa family niyo talaga yung ano, family of singers din pala talaga kayo.
So siya po yung nagturo po sa akin ng mga basics, yung mga proper breathing techniques.
Mm-mm. And then after The Voice nga, sumunod na si Your Face sounds
Your
familiar.
Face. Ito,
like
ito,
yung other photo mga kanina.
Ito po.
Sino naman yung pinakanahirapan kang gayahin?
Pinakanahirapan po kong gayahin si... Actually po, medyo nahirapan din po kay Liza Minnelli, pero favorite ko po siya.
So yan, yeah, Your Face sounds familiar. And then, ano yung next photo natin?
The next photo is Matilda the Musical.
Ooh.
This was in 2017. This came before this. This was 2018.
Mm-hmm.
And then, ito po yung second musical na nasalihan ko po. And this was a very surreal journey. Kasi po, yung nakuha ko po talagang role is as Matilda herself. And yung... a musical is Matilda.
Yeah.
Nakuha ko po lead role, and when I auditioned, I genuinely thought na talaga, I didn't really expect myself to, you know, be Matilda.
Matilda na.
I just expected to be like a part of the kids, yung classmates ni Matilda. So, mm-hmm. Ito din po yung, dito din po na-establish yung mas, yung confidence ko po further in the musicals. Kasi po, mas matagal din yung exposure niya sa stage, tapos madaming imememorize na lines.
Ano yung nauna? Kasi I heard na nag-ano ka rin eh, Les Miserables.
Les Miserables. Ay, wala po dito. Pero nag-Les Miserables din po ako. Tapos,
yun yung first one mo?
Opo, yun yung first musical po na sinalihan ko po. I got Little Cosette as, you know, my role po. Tapos, yun din po yung, since yun po yung first, and yun din po yung cast, international. So, mga British, Australians.
So talaga na-expose ka sa industry of musicals.
Hindi lang po yun. Parang hindi po talaga ako fluent mag-English nun. Medyo nahirapan po ako mag-English nun. So, medyo mahirap po makipag-communicate sa kanila. But at the same time, it was really easy kasi they were all outgoing and very accepting of...
Yeah, parang everyone's really adjusting din naman to help you out also.
Opo.
Grabe, anday mo agad nagawa, no? Imagine that. O, diba? From singing to doing acting also sa mga musicals. Yan na ating napag-usapan na. Pero of course, we have a lot more to talk about when Brgy returns.
What's your name?
I'm Kylie po.
Hi, Kylie.
I just wanted to ask po, other than the genre that you do, what other genres do you want to try po in the future?
Sa mga gusto ko i-try na genre, I want to try siguro, gusto ko mag-try na medyo pop na reggae. Kaya ganda ng question na yun. Thank you, Kylie.
Thank you po.
Jeez.
Hello po. Kung hindi ka singer and songwriter ngayon, ano kaya yung career na pinursu mo tapos naging successful ka rin?
Siguro dalawa lang pinagpiliin ko. It's either mag-film ako or mag-music ako. Pangarap ko talaga maging director. Sa creative side, in making stories siguro, directing, ganun, doon ako mag-excel kung hindi ako naging singer-songwriter. Film talaga yung papupuntahan, pero sabi ko, tinawag ako ng pagkakataon eh. So nag-risk ako na pumunta ng Manila from Cebu, and ayun, binigay naman ni Lord sa akin. Kaya, ayun. Tsaka dahil din talaga sa inyo yun, man. Maraming salamat.